Hello students, good evening. Welcome in your classroom that we will start with your physics 12th class and our chapter first, electric charges and fields. Electric charges and fields, and we have discussed many topics to related this. And we have discussed many points related this, that what was, first of all we discussed the what is the electrostatics exactly, after then we discussed the Coulomb's law and electric field, after then electric potential also, yes, and we in your last class that we discussed the Gauss we will discuss on. Applications of Gauss law. But today we, Mr. student, then you can understand that we in our last class we discussed what? That we discussed the Gauss law, and after then we discussed that some numericals related this. Yes, you know exactly. Now that what is the applications? Application means that we can use in a wire, if we are just taking a wire and that it charge uniformly charge, and then we are finding the Gauss electric field. That, you know, student, what was the use of Gauss law? That Gauss law was the using for electric field, find out the electric field at a given point P of HV is that you, if you want to that if the point is in the inside or outside, that depends on the applications exactly. So that now we are discussing the applications of Gauss law, and number one today we will discuss on field due to infinitely long and straight uniformly charged wire. That is, friend, then you can understand. Today we will, first of all, we are reading the application with a uniformly long straight wire. Okay, now before to start it, then I want to just clear everything. Field, what we are consider, because why we are taking application of Gauss law, because we are considering electric field, and due to which one, what is the where we are finding the electric field? A infinitely long straight wire means, infinitely long means that how much long this one wire, we are not identified. Yes, that we cannot say this is 20 meter long, 30 meter long. It is infinitely long wire. Okay, and uniformly charged wire means this one wire is a uniformly charged, means a fixed charge is on this wire, and it is distributed on infinite wire, over an infinite wire. Means if you are taking a small part of this, that the same charge will be here, and if you are taking a after 50 meter along a wire, that there will be, you find a small part, if you are taking that, the same charge will be there. So it is a uniformly charged wire. So now we are going to start with a field due to that field due to infinitely long wire. Yes, and now I will discuss many more things to related this one. Okay, so first of all, I am taking about infinitely long thin straight wire. Okay, and how this one tie, this type. This is a wire. Of course, there is a what there is a thin thin very thin and a straight wire, and uniformly charged wire is here. Suppose that I am taking a positive charge. I am taking a positive charge, and the charge density, now we were just discussing the what is the density. A long straight wire has a charge density, that you know about it. The charge density, what is lambda? Charge density is lambda. After then, what suppose that we are taking here, and the radial vector, I am taking a radial vector. What? And there is given that the wire is obviously an axis of symmetry. Axis of symmetry means I am just taking with a x direction. In which x direction? X direction means how much it is in positive y, that it will be in negative y. And symmetry means if you want to just cut in the two pieces, that you will find the same portion is in left hand side and same portion in right hand side exactly. And suppose we are taking the radial vector from O to P. O is its origin, and P is outside of this point. Okay. Take a radial vector. We are taking a radial vector. We are denoting with this small r is a radial vector. Then student, and now you will understand the what is the radial vector. Now I am just telling you what is the radial vector. There, a radial unit vector will always be along the radius and the tangential vector. Okay. First of all, I am just telling you that what is the radial and what is the tangential. The radial vector is, suppose that this radius is r. The radial vector will be in the direction of radius. In the radius. And what is the tangential? A tangential is this one type, that is a touching or a this one curve at only a point. Only a point. Understood? Yes. Exactly. So we are taking a radial is unit vector will always be along the radius. I am just writing here radial vector. What is a radial vector? A radial vector A radial vector, unit vector. Okay, unit vector will always be along the radius. Okay, and now yes, come to the point. The points are what? At P we have to discuss the electric field. Okay, we are finding out the at point P the electric field. And what I am saying, I am taking a at point P, and now I just take the point P dash. P dash is in this direction and P double dash in this direction. Okay, so what you are considering, they consider a pair of line elements. Suppose that this is with origin, okay, and this is also with the origin, and this one is also. So what is that you will see here the what is it is making? It is a making in a circular motion. It is making in a circular motion. And the direction of electric field at every point must be radial. Radial means outward. Radial electric field in this direction, and if you are going with this, then in this direction, because there is also a radial that in this direction. Exactly, yes. So consider a point of line elements are P1 and P2 of the wire as shown. The electric field produced by the two elements of the pair when is radial, the component normal to the radial vector cancel. Now to calculate the electric field, now we are making a Gaussian surface for this wire. What? Gaussian surface. Okay, then what is it will make a Gaussian surface? A long infinitely straight wire, if it there this one, that it will be make a, just we are taking a what, a long cylindrically Gaussian surface. This is a Gaussian surface. Gaussian surface. And at point P we are denoting here. And what you are understanding? Yes, exactly. And R is here radial vector. Yes. Now to calculate the field, imagine. Now we are calculating the electric field. The electric field. Now students, what you can understand, first of all we will see the flux through the where it is going, the flux is coming outside. Yes or no? Exactly. Now what you will see here, the electric field direction is what? This one. And of course if radial vector in this direction, that this one. So then you can understand what is the electric flux. Electric flux is phi is equals to E dot ds. Exactly, yes. Now you can see here how many surfaces are here. Then you will see there, if you are making, because Gaussian surface in a cylindrically way. Okay, and then you can see that there are the three, 1, 2, and three surfaces are here where the electric flux is passing through this cylindrical Gaussian surface. So number 1 and number 2, then what you can see here, this is making a what? Circular path. Yes, yeah, exactly. And this one is same. So the 1 and 2 both are same. Yes, you know, exactly. Now then what you are seeing here, that the surface S1 and surface S2, the surface S1 and S2 with making an angle with electric field is what? 90 degree. Mean these are not perpendicular. This is not parallel, these are, this is the perpendicular, means that E perpendicular to S1 and E perpendicular to S2. Yes, you know exactly, then you can see in your diagram. So what you are understanding, after then you can understand that S1 and S2 are same, and phi 1 and phi 2 are, wait, yes, then phi 1 and phi 2 both are same, and what are they are taking, that a cos of 90 degree, that is making a zero, that is making a zero. Now only one flux is remaining here. What is that? Is it passing through the curved surface? Now I'm just writing here that phi 3 is not equals to zero because the flux is, the flux passing through the curved surface, the curved surface. Yes, now you can understand. Yes, so how, but now the point is here, the how much it is, so we will calculate the how much phi 3, how much is phi 3. Sorry student, but I have to take a new board because of there today it's not proper working properly here, that's why. Okay, so phi 3, what is the phi 3 will be, that E dot ds 3 exactly, and electric field in same with ds, that is making a cos of 0 degree, then the total will be E ds 3. Yes, you know, and you know student, this, what is the Gaussian surface in a cylindrical path, Gaussian surface in a cylindrical path, then you can see here what, that the curved surface area for cylinder, I am just writing here the curved surface area for the cylinder, cylindrical path, then how much it will be, then you can understand that it will be S3, what, 2 pi, that is radius is how much, this is small r and 2 pi, and for the cylindrically path, the curved part, just I am just taking here, L is length of the cylinder, L is the length of cylinder. Okay, yes, and students, what we are measuring here, we are taking the two points on the wire P1 and P2 of the wire. The electric field produced by the two elements of the pair when some give a resultant electric field which is radial component normal to the radial vector cancel out. Okay, this is true for any such pair, and hence the total electric field at point P is radial. That we discuss in this line in your next chapter. Okay, yes, so S3 is coming 2 pi RL. Now the flux through the Gaussian surface, the flux through the Gaussian surface Gaussian surface is how much? Then you can understand that phi 3 is equals to E into 2 pi R L. Yes or no? Yes, exactly. Equation number 1. And the surface includes charge. Surface includes charge. So that you know, students, what is that we know from the Gauss law. What that what is you know that Gaussian that Gauss law is phi is equals to what? Yes, Q upon epsilon naught, where Q is the total charge. So we are finding the value of phi, that what we can write here, that Q upon epsilon naught. Exactly. And with charge density, we know what? The charge density is lambda is equals to what? Then you know dq by L. Yes or no? Yes. So what we can write here, that q is equals to lambda into L. So I am just putting this equation number 2 and equation number 3 in equation number 2. So phi is equals to lambda L upon epsilon naught. Equation number 4. Yes or no? Then you find out this one equation. Now we will compare with equation that what? That E into 2 pi R L is equals to how much? There is given lambda L upon epsilon naught. Then you can see here the L is going to be cancelled out. Then E is equals to what? Lambda upon 2 pi epsilon naught to R. And vectorically E at point is given in with n cap. Vectorially, and what is the n cap is here? The n cap is the radial unit vector in the plane normal to the wire passing through the point E. Yes or no? Yes. And directed now depend on the two things. What the charge density? Charge density for a wire, what is here? Lambda. Now if the lambda is greater than zero, so the electric field will be what? Positive. And positive means radially outward. Exactly. Yes. And if lambda is less than naught, so what will be? The E will be negative. Negative means then what you can understand, the electric field direction will be what? Positive to negative. So it will be inward. Exactly. Now you can see here the electric field around us in long wire, whether the effect of may be ignored many are, then you are finding the electric field at lambda upon 2 pi epsilon naught r with n cap, and n cap is the radial unit vector. What? Radial unit vector in the plane normal to the wire. So students, we find out the use of the application of Gauss law, and where we are using the what? So flux also, and the Gaussian law. Yes. And Gaussian law, or of course charge density, because it's so important, the charge density. And we you keep in your mind, for a wire the charge density will be lambda, and for a surface the charge density will be sigma, and also the for a volume, the charge density will be what? Yes, tell me, rho. What will be rho? Yes, this was the first application of Gauss law. Please, if you want to note down this one point, then you can note down in your notebook. Electric field, yes, you can directly apply in a question. The electric field due to an infinitely long straight wire, that how much electric field is lambda upon 2 pi epsilon naught r. And what is r is here? R is the distance where the at point P, which point you given in question, that you have to find out the electric field. Lambda is the charge density and epsilon naught is the permittivity. Exactly, yes. That this was the conceptually that we prove the electric field. Yes, and now we will discuss the second application of Gauss law. What? That the second law for the application, that what field due to a uniformly charged infinite plane sheet. What? Plane sheet. Then students, before to start, then you can understand what is the plane sheet. What is plane sheet? That I am taking the plane sheet. Okay, this is x, this is y, and also z. Then you can understand this one is a plane sheet. And then you can understand the plane sheet. What? Plane sheet has a breadth and also length, so it is making about area. Yes, exactly. Then what will we discuss with the area? So uniformly surface charge density, what will be that? Uniformly surface charge density will be what? Sigma. That you know, understand exactly. Now, and what we are taking? Infinitely plane sheet. What is infinitely? But we are taking the two points here in same case, that we are taking the two points here by symmetry of the electric field, not depend on the y and z coordinate and its direction. Exactly, yes, you know, yes. And we are making a Gaussian surface over a what? Rectangular parallel of cross sectional this one type, and in y and z axis there will be no electric field. Why? That you know already, because the flux is how much goes electric field in x direction, that it will make how much, that it will be make the angle with this, that will be 90 degree, and it is the perpendicular. So in this case it will be make the flux will be zero. So don't contribute the total flux is here. Now the unit vector normal to the surface, exactly, then you can understand here. And then I am just taking with the x direction, this is plus x direction and this is minus x direction. So what will be the unit vector normal to the surface? Now we have to consider only two surfaces are here, only one and two which are making the total flux. Otherwise, other side of this rectangle, other sides of this, these are making the electric field with angle is 90 degree, so these will be not contributing the flux. So now the only two surfaces are here, exactly one and two. Then you are seeing, students, ex and e with minus x. Then you can see here that I was just talking in your last time, that suppose that I am just taking e at one and plus x direction, then what you are seeing, that electric field is in x direction, the how much flux is here, that phi 1 is equal to e with ds. Yes, exactly. And what you are seeing, that e ds cos of theta, then theta is making what, how much, 0 degree. And you know that cos theta means cos 0 degree value is 1. So how much flux is passing through this one? That is phi 1. That phi 1 is E into ds. Exactly equation number 1. And in same case, I am taking the phi 2. That is passing through this one 1 and this is 2. And in this is it is making angle with how much, 180 degree, that theta is 180 degree. So that phi 2 is equals to e ds cos 180 degree. And you know cos 180 degree what is, negative. And already in this direction e is or what, negative e. E d s equation number 2, the total flux, but total flux how much is passing through this one, then you can see the total flux, the total flux is what, phi 1 plus phi 2, and it is making the twice of e into ds. Exactly, yes. Now what is the second point? The second point is, then what is the ds? Then you know about it, this is the plane parallel seat. Exactly, yes. And what is the sheet area? I am just taking a area with s, okay, 2e into s phi. And you know with the gauss law, if you are using the gauss law, then how much gauss law, that phi is equals to what, Gauss law say that phi is equals to q upon epsilon naught. Yes or no? Equation number 1, equation number 2. After then you know what, the charge density. Charge density is what, sigma. And how much sigma? Sigma is what, that q upon a, that a I am just taking area s, area is equals to s. So sigma is equals to what, is q upon s. And I am taking the value with what, q, if I am just denoting that, how much, q is equals to sigma s. Equation number 2. Equation number 3, I am using the q in a phi. I am using the q in phi. Then how much is this one? That is, that phi is equals to sigma s upon epsilon naught, equation number 4. Now from equation number 1 and equation number 4. Then if you are putting the value of with this, how much you are getting, then you are getting that phi is equals to e into s. Yes, so put the value that sigma s upon epsilon naught is equals to what? E into s. So es will be cancel out, sorry, 2es. So how much e is you coming out? That sigma upon 2 epsilon naught, sigma upon 2 epsilon naught. So strength, then you can see with n cap, yes, vectorically, and n cap unit vector normal to the plane and going away from it, e is directed away from the plate. If sigma is positive, then towards, and the plate, if sigma is negative, so it will be inward. Now the above application of Gauss law has brought out on additional fact, e is independent of x also. Yes, then you can understand in this that the infinite plane sheet, there is no dependency of direction also x, that how much is that, it will be that sigma upon 2 epsilon naught. For a finite large planar sheet, it is approximately true if it's for middle region of the planar sheet. Okay friends, yes, now I think then you can understand what is the application of, then you now you find out the two prop ways. Number one, the application was an electric field due to infinitely long uniformly charged wire, and the second was the infinitely plane sheet due to the field, the infinitely plane sheet uniformly charged. Then you find out the, in both cases, the electric field was how much? That lambda upon 2 pi epsilon naught 0 r, and the electric field there was a sigma upon 2 epsilon naught. Yes. So what is the dependency here? Then you can see the infinitely plane sheet, that E is proportional to L and E is proportional to N, means the electric field always be proportional to the charge density, and infinitely long straight wire. And this one is infinitely long sheet. And what you are seeing here, the E is proportional to 1 upon R. 1 upon R means the electric field depend on the distance it is going. If it is in the point is inside, that it will be dig, how much it will be maximum, and the electric, if the distance is maximum, the electric will be minimum. And in same case, there is no dependency. If I am writing here, there is no dependency of the distance and in same manner, the all these things will be same. The electric field in for a infinitely plane sheet, that will be sigma upon 2 epsilon naught, and it does not depend on the distance. If this plus x, and it depends on the charge density. If this positive, that it will be outward, and if it is in negative, that it will be inward. Yes students, then you can understand we have not find out the two, we have find out the two ways, the number one field due to infinitely long straight wire charge wire, and the field due to a uniformly charged infinite plane sheet. Now the third application is given in your first chapter, the field due to a uniformly charged thin spherical cell, field due to a uniformly charged thin spherical cell. So we will start with this one. field due to a uniformly large thin spherical cell. Then students, because of this spherical cell, we are discussing in what is the cell? The cell is this one type. Okay, it is thin, like uniform, that you know, uniform charge density. Charge density will be what? Sigma, and a spherical cell and its radius is r. Its radius is r. Okay, and the field at point P, if you are finding here at point P, then we take the find out the electric field at any point P outside or inside can depend only on small r, and P is outside and it is the, I'm just saying, small r is the distance. So we are taking with the use of Gaussian law. So we have to make a first of all what Gaussian surface, and you are seeing here the spherical cell is here. So we have to consider a what? Spherical is a sphere of radius r. Exactly, yes or no? Yes. And which one? Center is all O, and it is a Gaussian surface. It is a Gaussian surface. Say Gaussian surface. And now consider a point. We have find out a consider a point outside. Now first time I am taking a outside of the cell. Number one, the field outside of the cell. Then you can see here that the point small r p is outside of the cell. If we are talking about the field inside, at what, where it point, that it may be the point inside, means there, it may be here. Yeah, exactly. So but now first point is here, the field is, we are taking the outside of the cell, and consider we have a point P, and we make a what, we draw a Gaussian surface with a Gaussian surface in a sphere, which one, which radius is small r, which center is O. Okay, and passing through it at point P. All points on this sphere are equal and relative to the given charge configuration. Yes or no? Yes. And the electric field at each point of Gaussian surface, that will be same magnitude E and along the radius vector at each point. Yes or no? Yes. Means the electric field will be in the direction of the inward, in radial radius vector, and radius vector is what, in radial vector. That's, so electric field is making the angle with r what is 0 degree. So the flux will be passing through the whole surface, magnitude will be same. Exactly, yes. The electric field at each point of the Gaussian surface therefore has the same magnitude along the radius vector at each point. Thus the electric field is making every point a parallel, and the flux through each element will be how much, that phi is equals to about E into delta S. Yes or no? Because radial vector in same direction, it is what is parallel. Parallel means cos of 0 degree. So how much it will be? Phi E into DS. Yes. Now that phi is how much? E del S. Equation number one. After then, you know the Gaussian surface is length is how much, the radius is small r. Exactly. and the charge enclosed in a surface by the Gauss law. We will find out the Gauss law. Then you know the Gauss law is, first of all, that how much, that phi is equals to delta S, and delta S for this sphere, what will be? 4 pi r square. Yes or no? Because the r is the outside radius, outside at point P the radius. So that E into 4 pi r square, equation number 2. And you know the Gauss law. Gauss law, what is the Gauss law? Is equals to phi is equals to sigma, q upon epsilon naught. How much? Q upon epsilon naught. Q upon epsilon naught. And you know, students, equation number 3. Now what we will use, then you know very well. Yes, tell me exactly, that we will use the density, charge density, the charge density sigma. How much is this? This one is q upon a, means s, q upon a. And for this one, what will be? The A will be, the S is capital R square. What? 4 pi R square. And now, Q is, then phi is that sigma into 4 pi R square upon epsilon naught. Equation number 4. And we will compare with equation number 2 and equation number 4. Then by equation 2 and 4. Now how much? The sigma into 4 pi r square upon epsilon naught is equals to E into 4 pi small r square. Yes, exactly. So that E is equals to how much? 4 pi is going to cancel out. That it is finding out sigma capital R square upon epsilon naught small r square. Yes or no? Yes. And if you are taking the electric field in this field, about how much you are getting? A q upon 4 pi epsilon naught r square, where the q is equals to how much? 4 pi r square. 4 pi r square, the total charge on the spherical cell. The total charge, how much is here? Q. That total charge. Total charge is Q is equal to 4 pi r square sigma. Yes or no? Yes. So we can denote it here. The 4 pi r square, we can, if we are just making it, suppose that what? E is equals to sigma r square divided by q naught small r square. I am just multiplying with what? 4 pi. How much? 4 pi. That 4 pi sigma r square, what is? This is the q upon what is remaining? 4 pi epsilon naught r square. Yes or no? Yes. So the electric field is directed outward. It depends on the, if charge is inside, that it will be what? it inward, and the charge is negative, that it will be, that if charge is outward, if Q is greater than 0, and the inward, if the Q is less than 0, that is exactly the field produced by a charge Q placed at the center O. Thus, the point outside the cell, the field due to uniformly charged cell, if the entire charge of the cell is concentrated at its center. It's concentrated at center. Means it depends on the distance. It depends on the distance. Okay, students. Now, the second point, the field inside the cell. Field inside the cell. The what is the point is here, the field inside the cell, the flux through the Gaussian surface as calculated, yes or no? Yes. But Gaussian surface encloses no charge. But the Gaussian surface encloses no charge. Right? Field inside the cell. Inside the cell, then you know here, if we are taking is this one cell, and this is the point with O, and radius is how much? Gaussian surface is this one. This is at P point, and small r, and this capital R,